got my sign. I've got my nail polish that matches the icon color. Let's talk about Copilot Studio. I'm all in on this and how amazing this is going to be for building agents. And agents is absolutely the word of Ignite. This is pretty much up front in the keynote here. So we're on the main stage with this stuff. Essentially, what we're doing here, now, this is not a rebrand, but Copilots and Agents, the language is shifting in a useful way here. So Copilots are the UI for AI. This is like the catchphrase that's been repeated over and over and over at Ignite. This is each individual person has a Copilot experience where they can go in and chat. It's like their interaction with the AI, but Agents are about transforming business processes, about automating things. And you might have hundreds or thousands of agents. And importantly, agents are not primarily about chat. Chat might be part of it, but as you'll see as we go through this, we're now starting to talk about multimodal with voice and images. We are talking about things that can operate in the background. So this whole world of Copilot Studio, this is how we build agents. And here are all of the new announcements that I'm going to be taking you through here. And there's quite a lot of them. I'm structuring this up as a top 10, but it's in a logical sequence. Number one here, autonomous agents. I actually have a more in-depth video on this if you'd like to kind of go deeper. The core concept here is that we move from agents where it's a chat experience. So this is pretty much all we've been used to up till now, is that you go in and you start chatting and you have some kind of chat session and you finish. An autonomous agent can be triggered by, and this is very similar to the concept of a workflow, but it's not the same, but it's starting to evolve what workflows can be and how we think about them. I'm going to be talking a lot about this on the channel, so please subscribe if this is something that you want to get across. This idea of transforming business processes with autonomous agents is going to be kind of the most interesting and important thing. So what we've got here is a trigger of some kind where you say an incoming email or run this on a schedule. Is this sounding familiar? This is the concept that we're used to with any kind of automation. But an autonomous agent isn't do this, then do this, then do this. You're not giving it any order. You're giving it a set of instructions, like you would brief a new employee. Here is what you're responsible for and how I want you to do it. Here is the knowledge that you have available. Here are the actions that I'm empowering you to take. And here is what I want to kick that off, what trigger I want to kick that off. So you end up with something here where you can automate processes and the agent actually takes all of those things and decides at the time it runs what it should do based on the instructions and the knowledge and the actions. You're not actually outlining the actions one by one. This is going to take us a while. I'm going to keep going over this as much as we need. And as I start to get my hands on it, because the Ignite announcement here is that it's available now. So I'm going to be working you through this and we're going to come up with use cases. But this is really about saying the agent takes the decision making. It will escalate to a human where it needs to. This is 100% the space to watch. I am so excited about this one. Maybe this is my favorite, I don't know. But we've got knowledge with Copilot Studio. So you're connecting to your enterprise knowledge sources. And one of the most common use cases we see is organizations connecting to SharePoint, especially for things like policy type documents. This is just like one of the absolutely critical use cases. So thank you, big improvements in that performance, particularly for SharePoint. There's a couple of things going on here. Copilot Studio uses an out-of-the-box language model that Microsoft provides. More coming if you want to know about bringing your own language model. Don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but it's there. So at the moment, that's now GPT-4.0, and in fact, GPT-4.0 mini. So this is the latest kind of language model that's available from OpenAI. So the performance of that compared to version 4 or version 3.5 is absolutely superior. So if you've been using this technology for a while, please go back and have another look at the quality of the answers you're getting right now, because this is a recent upgrade and you'll find, I'm already finding it's doing much better in terms of its ability to retrieve the right information and generate the right kinds of answers. And SharePoint. We have had up until now, when you connect to SharePoint through Copilot Studio, it uses what's called keyword indexing, which is not as good as where we're going, which is semantic indexing. So keyword indexing relies on the right words being there. Semantic indexing is all about a language model or an index that understands the relative meanings of words in proximity to each other, which means if you ask a question using a word that's not even in the source document, semantic indexing can interpret similar words that have a similar meaning and find that. So you should start to see vastly improved speed, accuracy, and performance on using SharePoint as a knowledge source, which is an absolutely key use case that a lot of people are into. Next up, we have a brand new feature that also helps improve the quality of your answers, which is called knowledge curation. Now, there are a few things going on here, but essentially this is about helping you understand if you've connected to knowledge, or especially if you've connected to multiple sources of knowledge in your Copilot Studio agent, how are those things performing? Where are the gaps and how can I address those gaps? This is going to be great. So first off, we have a way of getting visibility on for a knowledge source, how much is it being used, what's the error rate, what's the answer rate. So we've got visibility on the performance of each knowledge source. This is really cool. This is unanswered questions. It's starting to identify the gaps, and so that you can come in here and say, here's something that's missing, and then you can bring custom knowledge, you can bring other knowledge in to address just those particular gaps. So let's say you've got an agent that's pointed to your website, maybe a knowledge base somewhere. People keep asking questions. It's just not in those data sources, but you've got the answer in some other document or somewhere else, and you just need to bring that in. You can do that now. So first of all, one of the things it will do is suggest knowledge. So it will find sort of recently used or other relevant knowledge sources and suggest them for you. But you can come in here and do this custom knowledge. So this is an example of coming in and saying, we want to answer questions about this topic by using this table in Dataverse or this other piece here. This looks a little bit like the prompt builder, not by accident, same kind of technology going on underneath here. So you can just come in and kind of plug those gaps in the knowledge with those custom knowledge sources. The other thing you'll be able to do is to mark a knowledge source as an official source, and that means that it will be highlighted and returned first in the response. So if you've got things that you want to kind of prioritize over other things. So together, all of these features in knowledge curation are going to give you much more granular control, visibility, and the ability to kind of fill in those gaps in the knowledge, which is amazing. Now, Copilot Studio and Azure AI, these two things are best friends. This is not an either or situation. I see a lot of people asking, which one should I use? You can actually use both of them. Copilot Studio is this amazing tool where you can create the topics and orchestrate the conversation and map it all out with low code. But with Azure AI, you can just extend into that. And there are two amazing new features here, which are apparently the top things everyone has been asking for. So this is now, I think, going to bring these two things together in a way that is going to make everybody happy from both sides of the equation, because you don't have to start with Azure AI and end up in a situation where you are fully maintaining everything. But if you already have done that, you can bring that into Copilot Studio. So absolutely best of both worlds here. So like I said, there are two different aspects to this. I'm giving them each their own number because I think they deserve it. So the first one here is to bring your own knowledge from Azure AI. So if you've already done the work, you've got your own custom RAG, you've got your own custom indexing, you've done all of those things, you've got heaps of data sitting in Azure. And if you don't know what that terminology is that I'm just using, then this part isn't for you. That's okay. Someone else will know what this is about and can bring it into the low code tool for you. If you've done all that, you've invested all of that time in doing all of that custom work for what you want in Azure AI, you will now be able to bring it in. So this is a no-code experience to bring it into the Copilot Studio tool to make it part of your agent. It's just like adding any other knowledge source. Add SharePoint as a knowledge source, add Dataverse as a knowledge source, add Azure AI as a knowledge source, and you're done. And the other one here, incidentally, the Azure AI Studio is now Azure AI Foundry. That's another little incidental tip for you, something that was announced at Ignite as well. Bring your own models. There are more than 1,600 different models available to you inside Azure AI. And so if you want to choose a specific model, as I said earlier, if you're working with Copilot Studio just as it is, you're getting GPT 4.0, But if you want something different than that, if you've got a specialized use case, you want to bring in an industry model, a small language model, anything like that that you've built yourself, you'll be able to do that now. And that will come in as an action. So that comes into your Copilot Studio, building your agent, saying, hey, use this model in here. Now, obviously, there's some additional cost with that, but this opens up the way to be able to access your own knowledge, access your own model, everything you might hope for here as a way to extend that low-code tool into those deeper tools. Essentially, with all of this, it's a good idea to start with what you can do with Copilot Studio first, extend as you need to, unless you've already done all that work and you know that's where you want to be. Does not have to be either or. This one is super cool. I haven't got a live demo of this one yet, but I saw them do the live demo of this and it was definitely real because it didn't quite work 100%. So you got to love a live demo that proves that it is real. But this changes the idea of IVR solutions. Have you ever done that? Have you ever done that call? We've all done this, right? You call a customer service team. It says press 1 for this, press 2 for that, press 3 for that, or say the words out loud. But if you've just got another question you want to ask, it can't handle that. And some of the early voice recognition technology with this stuff was absolutely terrible. I'm sure we've all got our own bad experiences. So the concept here is multimodal agents. This means that we can use the agents we build in Copilot Studio for more than just text chat now. So this is an example of the demo that they did today where you can see we've got in here something that is about these DTMF keys. This is the press 1 for this, press 2 for that. So those are in there. But what we can do now is add knowledge. So all of the things that you can do in building an agent in Copilot Studio, like adding knowledge or adding actions, the agent doesn't care how the user is interacting with it. So the experience that we can have with all of these things where you can just type in the chat and it can answer a question from the, you know, the in-room dining, what's on breakfast menu today or whatever, you can do that in chat. This just adds another mode now. So you can talk voice and it will talk back to you in voice, but it's using exactly the same thing underneath. So it's just another way of interacting with it, but the underlying technology is exactly the same. It's very impressive. This is coming into early preview. I will have my hands on it and we will do some genuinely live demos on the channel. I know people get a little bit dubious when they see demos on the stage, but I'm prepared to go live once this is here and we can give it a test. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be a lot of fun. The other piece here is the new SDK. So this is essentially, if you're a professional developer, I'm talking to you now. If you're not, just kind of understand the concept of what's going on here. This allows you to access Copilot Studio endpoints with code, and it means you can embed the agents into websites and applications. Essentially, what this means is now you can have this, if you combine what we just had a look at, the multimodal Copilot, the multimodal agent, it's going to take a while for me to get the language right, multimodal agent into this new way of kind of embedding it in your app. The example they showed here is a hotel sort of concierge app where I'm in my hotel room and, hey, you know, what's available for breakfast tomorrow. With this SDK, it can actually then immediately redirect, instead of just going, hey, here's the information and here's a link, the experience for the person sitting using this app is that it just redirects to that and brings it up. And you can also have this voice mode as well. So I could sit and just chat to it. It can do all of those things. Number 8, analytics. We all love to understand what's going on. So we've already seen earlier that with the knowledge curation, you've got some more analytics about what's going on with your knowledge, but there's even more coming in here as well. So examples here of being able to switch from that sort of different kinds of charts in there. You've got a bit more flexibility with that. The data is being held for longer in here now. It's 90 days instead of 28. So you can get much more of a long-term view of what's going on. And more knowledge analytics in here as well. So like the knowledge is the main game, really, with all of this stuff. Knowledge is the power behind these agents that makes them incredibly valuable for businesses. So being able to see which of your knowledge sources are being used, how well are they being used, what are the outcomes there is great. This is cool. Pay as you go metered billing. I don't have a proper image for this. This is just like a placeholder image of an Azure billing thing. We've had something like this for Power Apps for a while. This is super important because it will unblock use cases where people have seasonal peak demand. So with the Copilot Studio licensing as it is, you're basically paying per month for a pack of a certain number of messages, but any business, and there are many, many of them that have a seasonal peak or a seasonal demand, you don't want to pay all year round for that many chats when you're only using them for a couple of months of the year or whatever that looks like for you. So new option coming here to have a metered billing to pay as you go. I don't have more detail than that yet. That's all that's been announced, but that is something if you are in that situation that's going to unblock that use case for you, which is wonderful. And I also wanted to draw your attention to the agent builder in Microsoft 365 Copilot, because this is also Copilot Studio. So if you're working with Copilot Studio and you've got those skills, this is the way that we extend the main game, extend the Microsoft 365 Copilot. So this agent builder experience starts off by saying, hey, build me an agent about this. And it's using a slightly different UI, but it's exactly the same thing underneath. So if you know how to Copilot Studio your agents, you know how to use the agent builder here as well. And now you've just got extra skills in your tool belt. Don't we love that? If you want to know more about Microsoft 365 Copilot announcements, I've got you covered here. And stay subscribed for more on Copilot Studio. I've got so much more coming. I've got a very long list of videos to make. Thanks for watching.